You may have heard people talk about your Google snippet or your metadata before and wondered, what is that or how do I change it? Well, the metadata is the way that your web pages and your post show up inside of the search engine results. So it's really important. Let's have a look at what it is, how you can change it, and how you can make it work the best for your business. Hi, I'm Alli, and I help emerging entrepreneurs level up their business online with a brand and website that helps them to make an authentic connection with their dream clients. And a great way to connect with your audience is to focus on your metadata so that when they see your website appear in the search engine results, they'll be more likely to click on your website. So what is metadata? Metadata is code written into your website that lets the search engines know what your site is all about. Now, just because I said code, please don't freak out. There's a really easy plugin to help you do this. The two pieces of metadata that we need to concern ourselves with are the page title and your meta description. Your page title is the title that you've given to your page or to your blog post. When you look at search engine results on Google, it's the clickable blue copy at the top line of the description. It also can be found in the tab of your web browser. Here's an example of a really good page title. It's a good one because it includes three things: the target keywords up front, the ones that they've specifically chosen and would like to show up for. Next up is the reason why someone should choose your site over another one. What's the benefit? And then your brand name. Keep in mind that your title should be limited to a maximum of 65 characters in order for it to fully appear here. Your metadata is the snippet of information that describes what your page is all about. It's the black section of copy that appears below the page title and the link in the search engine results. Your metadata is important because if it's really good, it can entice people to click on your site over any of the others that have been shown in the search engine results. And if you get high click-through rate, over time, Google will start putting your site higher in the search engine results.
Here's a good example of a meta description that works. It works well because it clearly lets us know what the page is about and lists the benefits we'll receive. They've given great reasons why we should click on their site instead of many others that show up alongside it. It's really important that you decide what shows up as your page description in the search engine results, because if you don't, Google will simply pull part of your page to put here, often truncating your text, causing it to end with an ellipses and often not be very compelling to the reader. You'll need to keep your description less than 155 characters to avoid this happening as well.
Keep in mind that what you write needs to be easily readable and sound like it's coming from a human. Nobody wants to read something that doesn't make sense and is just jam-packed full of keywords, and Google doesn't go for that kind of behavior either. So how do you go about changing how your website appears in the search engine results?
On a WordPress site, it's easy to do using a free plugin called Yoast SEO. In the dashboard of your site, go under Plugins, Add New, and then type in Yoast SEO in the search area, and then it will show up. You can click on Install Now, and then activate the plugin. Once the plugin's activated, head to the sidebar and hover over SEO and click on Search Appearance. Click on the Content Types tab and scroll down, and you can see where you can add in your SEO title and meta description site-wide. Now, if you click on Insert Variable, you can add in the title of your page or post and add a separator and then add in your site title. And this again would appear for every page. Then you can also add a site-wide meta description right here. Once you're done, click on Save Changes. You can also customize the appearance of what shows up in the Google snippet for each page or post of your site by going under Pages, All Pages, click Edit under one of your pages, and then scroll down and you'll find the Yoast SEO area where you have the ability to see how your site is currently showing up and make changes by adding in your own title. And again, you can insert the variable for a separator, and then you see the preview above as well as the site title. And again, you can see it previewed above here, which is really great. And then you can go ahead and add in your meta description right here and check out the preview. make sure everything looks good. And you can see the green line below showing you how many characters you've used up of the allotted amount, which is really helpful as well. Once you're all set, click on update.
Now that you know why and how you need to think about how your web pages appear inside of the search engine results, you may be wondering how you know what keywords to go after in the first place and what would be best for your business. So if that's the case, click this video that's on your screen right now where I cover just that. And click subscribe and the notification bell if you're loving all these tips and tricks about running your business online so you don't miss any of my upcoming videos. Now let's go get them.